Welcome back, everybody, to the Deep Space Divorce Saga.
Yes.
By John Oakley McElhenney.
Mm-hmm.
We are picking back up today.
Okay.
In a chapter titled Single Parent Moon Landing Into the Sea of Tranquility.
Ooh, that's a good one.
So last time we left off,
okay,
McElhenney was dealing with the initial shock,
yeah,
of the separation.
Right.
And now he's using this space travel metaphor,
right,
to describe, you know, this next phase of his journey.
Yeah.
What do you think about that?
Well, it is a clever analogy.
Yeah.
Because divorce, especially with kids, can feel like you're just launched into some unknown galaxy.
Right.
It's just disorienting.
Absolutely.
You lose all your bearings.
Right.
And I think McElhenney captures that perfectly,
yeah,
when he talks about having to abandon ship,
yeah,
as his marriage falls apart.
It's raw.
Yeah.
Like, you can almost feel the ground shifting beneath him.
I know.
But amidst all that chaos,
yeah,
he makes this realization that his most important mission now,
okay,
is to lead his kids,
yes,
through this turbulent time.
Absolutely. And it's not just about being there,
right,
you know, physically for them.
Yeah.
It's also being there emotionally.
Right.
He realizes he has to project strength, optimism, hope, even when he's not feeling it.
Right.
And I think that's a huge responsibility.
Yeah.
I think a lot of parents can relate to that.
Well,
how do you stay strong for your kids?
Exactly.
When you're barely holding it together yourself.
It's such a tricky balance.
It is.
Because you want to be honest with them.
Yes.
But you also don't want to burden them.
Right.
With your own baggage.
Exactly.
So how do you do that? How do you model that resilience?
I think one thing McElhenney does really well,
yeah,
is that he focuses on what he can control.
Okay.
He can't control the fact that his marriage is ending.
Right.
But he can control how he responds.
Okay.
He can focus on being the best dad he can be. He can create a stable and loving environment for his kids.
Right.
And that focus gives him purpose.
Yeah.
Even amidst all the uncertainty.
It's like choosing to be the captain of your own spaceship.
Yeah.
Even if you've been forced off course.
Totally.
You're still navigating.
Mm-hmm.
You're still in charge of your own destiny.
You got it.
And speaking of losing control,
oh,
McElhenney talks about being overwhelmed.
Yes.
By all the loss that he's experiencing, his home,
mm-hmm,
his financial stability,
yeah,
even his belongings are in storage.
Yeah, it's a lot to process.
It's a lot.
It is.
So how does he deal with that?
That's a great question.
Because it'd be so easy to just shut down.
Oh, absolutely.
Right.
He does something really interesting.
Okay.
Instead of dwelling on what he's lost,
mm-hmm,
he starts to reevaluate his priorities.
Okay.
He realizes that material possessions,
yeah,
financial security, mm-hmm, these things are replaceable.
Okay.
What really matters is his kids, and that becomes his guiding principle.
Yeah.
Kids first, huh, everything else second.
Right.
And that starts to shape all his actions.
And that leads to some big changes in his life, right?
Oh, yeah. I mean, changes. He transforms his work,
uh-huh,
focusing on projects that allow him to spend more time with his kids.
Okay.
He pours his energy into creative outlets.
Right.
Writing and filmmaking.
Mm-hmm.
He's rebuilding his life,
yeah,
piece by piece.
Right.
But always with his kids at the center.
It's a real testament to the power of refraying a setback as an opportunity.
Absolutely.
It's not being defined by this divorce,
yeah,
but using it as a catalyst for growth,
totally,
self-discovery,
mm-hmm,
and creating this new life that's even more aligned,
yes,
with his values.
I love that.
And that brings us to one of the more,
okay,
unexpected moments in the chapter.
Right.
The storage unit incident.
Oh, yeah. The storage unit incident.
This is where things get really interesting.
This is where it gets good.
Yeah.
Buckle up.
All right. So.
Yeah. So McElhenney's already going through so much.
Right.
And then he loses all of his remaining belongings.
Yeah.
In a storage unit auction.
Like, really?
Like, come on.
Can the guy catch a break?
Right. What else is going to happen?
Yeah, but you know what's interesting?
What's that?
He doesn't really react.
What do you mean?
Like, the way that you would think.
Okay.
He doesn't fall apart.
Okay.
He actually uses it.
Uses it for what?
To teach his daughter a lesson.
Oh, wow.
Turns this whole stressful situation,
yeah,
into a teaching moment.
I love that.
I know, me too.
So how does he spin this for her?
So he sits her down,
okay,
and explains that, you know, all that stuff.
The stuff in the storage unit?
Yeah. Oh. It's just stuff.
Okay.
It's replaceable.
Okay.
What really matters is their bond,
right,
their family,
uh-huh,
the experiences that they share.
Yeah.
And he tells her those are the things.
Yeah, that you can't lose in the storage unit auction.
Wow.
Right?
It's like material possessions don't define us.
That's exactly what he's saying.
Right.
It's the relationships that do.
But you know, it's so easy to get caught up in accumulating things.
It is.
And thinking that that's what brings happiness.
And it's like our consumer society.
Yeah.
We attach all this meaning to these objects.
Totally.
Like they represent our success.
Right, our identity.
Exactly.
So it's like you can't take it with you.
You can't take it with you.
But you can take the memories you make.
That's it.
The love you share.
Uh-huh.
The lessons you learn.
You got it.
So he's really leaning into this Captain Kirk persona.
He is.
Isn't he?
I was just thinking.
Leading his crew through this uncharted territory.
Yeah, his family's his crew now.
Right, exactly.
That's a good coping mechanism.
It is.
By embracing that leadership role.
Right.
He's giving himself and his kids a sense of purpose and direction.
It's like he's creating a story to help them make sense of it all.
Yeah.
Instead of being these passive victims.
Yeah.
They're active participants.
That's a good way to put it.
In their own adventure.
Totally.
I think it's really interesting.
What's that?
You know, when you were talking about McElhenney focusing on what he can control.
Yeah.
It's like by choosing to be the captain of his family.
Right.
He's taking charge.
He's taking control.
Of the one thing he can control.
Totally.
His response to the situation.
Exactly.
And it's not just modeling that resilience for his kids.
Mm-hmm.
But it's also reaffirming his own sense of self-worth and capability.
Like, even though the ship might be taking on water, he's still the captain.
Right.
He's still responsible for getting his crew to safety.
And I think that's such a powerful message.
It is.
Not just for parents going through a divorce.
Right.
But anyone facing a challenge.
Cool.
It's a reminder that we always have choices.
We do.
Even when we feel powerless.
I love that.
We can choose to give up.
Yeah.
Or we can choose to keep fighting.
Keep fighting.
Keep leading.
Yeah.
Keep believing in a brighter future.
It's about having that agency, that belief in our own ability to get through tough times.
And emerge stronger.
Emerge stronger, yes.
So his story is really...
It's raw.
Yeah.
It's honest. Yeah. It's messy.
It is.
But ultimately,
yeah.
a story of hope and resilience. You know, it's interesting how this whole experience almost forces McElhenney to embrace this minimalist lifestyle.
It does.
Like losing everything in the storage unit.
Yeah.
Really strips him down to the bare essentials.
Right, and it's not about the stuff.
No.
It's about his relationships,
yeah.
his resilience, his creativity.
Exactly.
Like, those are the things that define him.
I agree.
Not his possessions.
I think it brings him a sense of freedom.
Yeah.
There's this lightness that emerges in his writing. Like a sense of liberation from all that stuff.
Like, it's not just about letting go of physical objects.
Yeah.
It's like letting go of old identities.
Exactly.
Old expectations. Maybe even old resentments.
Yeah. It's about shedding those layers.
Right.
That don't serve us anymore.
That are weighing us down.
Yeah.
And preventing us from moving forward.
It's a metaphor for transformation.
Yeah.
Like, we all go through this.
But what can people listening take away from this?
Well, I think the biggest takeaway is that resilience is a choice.
Okay.
It's not about avoiding hardship.
Right.
It's about how you respond to it.
So how did McElhenney respond?
Well, he could have just given up.
Right.
But he chose to find meaning and purpose.
In his experience.
And what happened to him,
And it seems like his optimism plays a big role in that.
It does, because even when things are tough,
he
still finds a way to laugh,
right.
to find the humor, to believe that there's a brighter future out there.
He's like, life threw a curveball.
Yeah.
But I'm going to swing at it anyway.
You got it.
And I'm going to make the best of it.
That's a really empowering message.
It is.
It's a reminder that we have more control than we think.
Over our own lives.
Yeah.
That was amazing.
It was.
Don't stop now. Mm. Join us on the next rocket ride of love.
Okay.
When we tackle a chapter titled, The Crew Must Survive.
I can't wait.
Until next time.
Yes.
Keep your kids close
mm-hmm.
and your crew safe.
Sounds good.